Don't you dare go giving up.
G-O-O-D-M-O-I-N-I-E, good morning. Good morning. Good morning, scholars.
Good morning,
scholars.
Good morning,
Mr. Crew. It's a little better, good. I know it's Monday morning. You guys may feel like, oh, I'm a little tired from the weekend. Let's take a few minutes to say what we did this weekend. Just one thing we did this weekend. One thing. Can somebody give a volunteer? What's one thing you did this weekend? I painted at my school, so I'm hanging up there.
I went to Six Flags.
She went to Six Flags. All right, get some snaps for that. Give me something else somebody did. This is how you build community. Like, what we doing out here when we a family and we disperse and we go our separate ways? What we doing?
A couple hands over
here. What we do this weekend? Give them two claps on two. One, two.
Went to Florida.
Went to Florida? Oh, give them two claps for Florida on two. One, two. Okay, give two claps for the Six Flags as well. One, two. Good. Come on, give me somebody else. What you do this weekend? One more person. Give them a deal. It's T.
Oh, no, that's funny.
Oh. Girl, what you do this weekend? Water balloons. That sounds so fun. You got your uniform, Shannon. Is it your birthday? What? Oh, your dolls. Okay. Give two claps for dolls on two. One, two. And give two claps for water balloons on two. One, two. We got a few things. So we're about to get ready for our wonderful, amazing devotion. God's love is out of this. God's love is out of this. No. You don't understand. Like, you got to make it sound like you're trying to reach out of this world. Are you ready? God's love is out of this. Introducing Coach Meyer.
Forgive me because of Jesus.
Jesus always lived with responsibility.
responsibility in your place and paid for your lack and my lack of responsibility on the cross. You are forgiven, children of God, loved and saved by Jesus. That is the truth. You know this verse now. 145 verse 74 says, now bring a little game to it. Psalm 147 verse 4 says,
He has the number of stars. He calls them all by name.
Jenga. Most of y'all played it. You know at the end of that game, somebody's going to lose, right? All the blocks are going to come crashing down.
Yep.
Except, if instead of pulling the blocks out, you start putting the blocks back in. Every time in the game of Jenga, in the game of life, somebody puts you down. Every time somebody tells you a lie. Every time that we're verbally abused, sexually abused, treated terribly. A little piece of our heart, a little piece of our body, as we age, as we get older, those Jenga pieces keep getting pulled apart. And today we're going to see the miraculous. We're going to see a young man lean into Jesus and trust him. And the Jenga pieces are going to miraculously put back together. You and I, through faith in Jesus Christ, when the Jenga pieces all come crumbling down, through faith in him, they're put all back together. This young boy right here, I don't know how blurry that is, if you can see or not. He taking his hand, he's putting that little piece back in the Jenga game. He's being Jesus to somebody else. He's putting the Jenga piece back together so it's strong. Notice where he puts the piece. On the bottom. Why the bottom? Why is it so critical that he takes that Jenga piece and puts it on the bottom? Why is that key? Thank you.
Build a foundation.
Amen, sister. Build the foundation. That's what you're doing here today. Again, a whole bunch of your friends ain't here today. They ain't here. You are. You're building the Jenga game back up by faith in Jesus, by building your knowledge in the game of life. What are some ways we care for the young? Some of you have younger brothers and sisters, younger cousins, younger friends, right? I know you have. You don't even have to put your hand up because I know. Look up on top up there. It's Emmy. Her mother has cancer. I worked really closely with her mother for many years. But you notice, I know it's a little small picture, but she's got her baby. The one thing that's precious to her, she has her in a car seat. And even though she has cancer, she's caring for her kid because she knows. She doesn't know if tomorrow, the next day, or a month from now, or 3 years from now, the game of Jenga is going to end. And she wants to make sure her daughter is protected. Up on the top right, this is a student of mine from Hope High School about 12, 13 years ago. Her daughter, about a year ago, Caitlin was baptized. Bottom right, this man I respect a lot. I coached his brother. That's probably 20 years ago by now. Somebody I respect a lot. You can see, again, caring family for their kid. Some of you know Chaplain Jackson. This young man here about 3 months ago was baptized because the game of Jenga is going to end. And what's going to matter is our faith in Jesus. He's the one that can build the Jenga game back. He's the one that can make a difference forever. We take care of our young by giving them a doctor. That's important. Caring for our bodies, our health. It's important. This young lady here is an eighth grade student of mine. She's like fifth or eighth grade. She's the number five triple jumper in the United States right now. You can Google her. Her name's Jaya Hawk. She's a Demon Deacon down in most north of Chicago, at DePaul. When she was in eighth grade, there were 6 a.m. track practices at St. Marcus. I said, hey, Jaya, she's a tremendous 200 runner, 200 yards, just amazing. I said, Jaya, I think you should do the triple jump. She's like, man, I ain't feeling that. she was kind of embarrassed. She wanted her friends to kind of put her down. She was a little scared. I said, Jaya, I think you should do triple jump. I think you could be really, really good. Fortunately, she listened. That girl, like I said, number five, look what she's doing though. She's giving back. She's training other youngins. They're building. Probably celebrating a birthday, right? She's being about other people. Look at this picture closely. Let's assume for a second there's no mom, no dad, nobody else there. They've got, this picture starts off pretty good, right? You can see a sister caring for a little brother. What do you think's gonna happen if there's no adult in that room? Let's say 15 minutes from now. What's that gonna look like? Probably gonna be some strawberries everywhere, milk in the little baby's face, young boy's face, right? It's gonna get messy. That Jenga game is gonna come crashing down. Here's a young man about 3 months ago. Was baptized. Both of these guys were baptized before I thought. Hope Semple. Notice what he's doing. Older brother. Look what it says. I know it's a little hard to read. It says, he is risen. And he's showing little boy how to color. How to love up Jesus. How to be loved by Jesus. Make sure his little brother knows that when the Jenga game ends, he knows. Jesus is. He is risen. And because he rose, we too will. Today our story, our story today is a man named Jairus. And I know it's a little bit small, I may not see the whole thing. I'll get it so you can see it another time. I might even do a little coloring thing with this. But we have a couple people in the background. See, Jesus didn't go show this miracle off. It's one of the first ones he does. Not the first, but one of the first ones he does. And he doesn't want to show off, so he invites James and John, his close to Peter, his close disciples, into the room. And he invites the mother and father into that room. Here's the scripture. Mark 5, 22-24. Then one of the synagogue leaders, and already he had no power to him, named Jairus, came. And when he saw Jesus, he fell at his feet. Man with authority, and he falls to the ground, bowing before Jesus. He pleaded earnestly, my little daughter is dying. Please come and put your hands on her so that she will be healed and live. So Jesus went with her. I want you to look into that picture right there. I want you to look at his eyes. You know, when you've got a lot of pain going on, when you got a lot of hurt, when things aren't going all good, when Jenga knocking you over, when your daughter is on the depth of dying, when you see your grandma pass on, when you lose your mother or father, when a little great brother or sister's gone, his eyes are hurting, but look where they're at. They are locked in on Jesus. They are locked in because he believes that Jesus is who he said he was. See, there's only three things Jesus can be. He can either be crazy, a total liar, or the Son of God. Those are the only choices. Well, was he crazy? No, he ain't crazy. Was he a liar? No, he ain't a liar either. So he is who he said he was. And he's going to show that to this man and everybody in that room. Give all your worries to him because he is the one who cares about you. I don't know what exactly your Jesus looks like. I've done a number of paintings of Jesus. I don't know what he looks like in your heart. But I know he's the truth. I know he's the way. I know he's the life. And I know he's the one that makes the difference not only in your life right now, in eighth grade, K-5, second grade, third, whatever that is, or 52 years old and old like me. Jesus is the answer. So let's give our fingers up. Here we go. Bring your fours up. Thank you. Here we go. Give them all for Jesus. He's the one who died for us. Ready? Here we go. Make it first. Ready? Go. Jesus, God for me. Amen. Take that truth with you. Who are you?
I am a child of God, loved and saved by Jesus.
Let's pray. a lot of people in this room who've dealt with a lot of hurt. A lot of rejection. A lot of times when doubts maybe aren't there for them. But you are, God. You are always there. To the point of raising a young girl who's 12 years old to life. Lord, help us to lead in that kind of confidence today that you are real, that you're not a lunatic, you're not a liar, but you are the truth, the way, and the life. Amen.
Amen.
Bring your hands up. Again, this is through my words, but it's coming from the living God, the one that matters. He says, the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
Friday. I'm trying to see if we can even get in the church, but we're going to have a baptism bowl up here. Anybody who would like to be baptized, you have a permission slip, okay? Talk to me. I'll be around today. I'll be around each day a little bit, okay? Talk to your teacher. Talk to your parents. We'd love to have you do that. And then there's another form that your teachers are giving to you, and that is to help you with your earthly life as well. Okay? Volleyball in our city is a great, great, great game. Great game. It's one of the best ways to get involved as you pass on to high school, playing in grade school. We have a group of people from the United States Volleyball Association. In other words, they're like the best of the best in the United States. They're going to be at St. Marcus on August 12th. Okay? This form I gave to you, probably the easiest thing to do is either text me, text the number on that sheet right there, okay? And they'll get you all the information. I think there might be a link on there, but I'm not 100% on that. Just text, Subcuck is his name. He is the athletic director at St. Marcus. He's a tremendous dude, cares a lot about kids, all right? Wants to see you do well. So anybody who's interested, and I'm talking if you're interested at all, you might be just a little bit interested. It's K-5 all the way up, okay? So that's volleyball. It's another great opportunity for you. I'm turning the floor over to you, Mr. Coop.